In this video, we will explain the considerations that need to be taken into account when choosing an appropriate read block size for a data recovery disk imaging job. We will also show how to manually configure the long physical sector imaging algorithm on drives which do not self-report their long physical sector parameters. According to ATA specification, data must be requested from hard drives in blocks of sectors. The size of one block can range anywhere from one sector to 65,536 sectors. When we are dealing with healthy devices, we would normally want to use a large read block size because it would speed up the rate at which data can be accessed. However, everything changes when we start working with damaged devices. If even a single sector within the requested block can't be accessed by the drive for any reason, then the entire read command will fail and no data will be retrieved. In other words, even if we request 100 sectors from the drive, and as a result it successfully reads 99 sectors and fails to read one sector, the response to our command will be an error without any data. We will not receive the data from the 99 sectors that the drive was able to read. This is something we have to keep in mind when determining the best read block size to use for our data recovery imaging job. When choosing the block size, we have to be mindful of the frequency as well as the distribution of bad sectors. Our goal is to reduce the total number of failed read attempts during the imaging job and to increase the amount of data being recovered. Generally speaking, the more unstable the drive, the smaller the block size that we will want to use with it. For example, if a hypothetical drive has a single bad sector every 1,000 sectors, then using a read block size of 1,000 would not yield us any data, while a block size of 100 would retrieve 90%. Larger block sizes can still make sense in some cases of heavy read instability. If the bad sectors happen to be consistently grouped together into a particular pattern, then we would want our block size to take that into account. The core idea is to choose a block size large enough so that it would fit the common bad sector groupings within it. For example, if bad sectors come in groups of 50, then using a block size of 10 will result in us hitting each bad sector group 5 or 6 times each, which is inefficient and unnecessary. A better choice would be to set the block size to a value higher than 50 so that each bad sector group is accessed only 1 or 2 times. In this example, the larger the block size we choose, the fewer times we will access each bad sector group on average, which is lighter on the drive. At the same time, a larger block size would decrease the amount of data being recovered because we would be skipping more sectors with each failed read command. It's a trade-off between drive stress and the amount of data being recovered. Now let's try it on a real drive. First, we start imaging using default settings, which will use a read block size of 120 sectors. The DeepSpar disk imager does not allow block sizes larger than 120 because the high performance of its architecture makes it so that increasing the block size past that point does not improve the imaging speed any further, but it still carries the corresponding negative side effects. As you can see, a high percentage of sectors are coming back yellow, meaning that the drive is frequently not responding to us within the timeout period. This is an indicator of at least one bad sector being present within each yellow block. The problematic sectors on this drive appear to be spread out rather than grouped together. We imaged 1 million sectors in 60 seconds and left behind 27,600, or about 2.7% of sectors. Leaving behind that many sectors spread out along the drive will cause a lot of our recovered files to be corrupted and unusable. Such an image is very low quality, so we should do something to improve it. Given that we saw a high percentage of yellow blocks spread out evenly, we should decrease the read block size to a smaller value in order to retrieve more sectors. After changing it to 24, we can see that we are leaving behind much less data. With this change, we have made it image a bit slower, so that it took 70 seconds instead of 60. However, the number of missed sectors decreased by more than 5 times, down to 5,496. If we had allowed a second imaging pass to run on all the previously skipped sectors, then the end result would have been similar for both block sizes. However, in this case, using a smaller block size on the first pass has the added advantage of producing a higher quality image earlier, which can be critically important if the drive happens to fail or degrade further prior to reaching the second imaging pass. It's a good idea to get used to setting block sizes in multiples of 8, because many modern drives use physical sectors that are 8 logical sectors in length. A physical sector is the smallest amount of data that the drive can access at one time. So if we request 1 logical sector, or half a kilobyte, from a long physical sector drive, it will first read the entire 4 kilobyte physical sector that the requested logical sector belongs to. Then it will pass on the requested logical sector through the bus as a response to our command and discard the other 7 logical sectors that were also read from the same physical sector. In data recovery, we do not want to discard any of our recovered data, so it makes a lot more sense to align our read commands with the physical sector boundaries of the drive. This will ensure that we actually retrieve all the data that the hard drive reads. In most cases, the DeepSpar disk imager will handle this automatically in the most efficient manner. However, some drives do not report that they are using long physical sectors, and in those cases, manual configuration is required. The 2 adjustable parameters are the number of logical sectors per physical sector and the offset. Most modern drives have 8 logical sectors per physical sector, and some rarer drives have 2. The offset is the number of logical sectors missing from the first physical sector. Some drives use an offset of 1 to align the drive for older variants of NTFS, which stored blocks of metadata starting on logical sector 63. The correct long physical sector settings can be determined manually just by watching the imaging process run with a read block size of 1. Drives that use long physical sectors will always have their logical bad sectors come in fixed groups. All we need to do is identify groupings of bad sectors next to one another to determine how many logical sectors the drive keeps in one physical sector. For example, for this drive it's clearly 8. The offset is calculated by taking the first logical block address of any bad physical sector, dividing it by the number of logical sectors per physical sector, and subtracting the remainder from 8. For example, if we spotted a bad physical sector which is 8 logical sectors in length, and which starts on LBA 100,007, we can calculate the offset by dividing 100,007 by 8, which leaves us a remainder of 7, meaning the first physical sector is 7 logical sectors in length, which is an offset of 1. Thanks for watching.